Hello students, welcome to another screencast. This is John Mendiola, and we're looking at sans serif group number one, and this typeface is Helvetica. Now, Helvetica, when you look at it, you might think to yourself, gosh, you know, there's just not a lot I can extract from it as far as things that are memorable. And you're right, Helvetica is intentionally designed to be somewhat of an invisible typeface, meaning when you see something set in Helvetica, you kind of look right through it and go right to the content. Because the typeface is very unassuming, it doesn't grab you, it's not quirky, it doesn't have a lot of embellishments that are noteworthy, or I shouldn't say that are they're not overly exciting or crazy visually. But there are a few things we can still look at to tell that something is Helvetica. First of all, pretty squarish, round typeface. Letters like the C, the S, the A, find a lowercase e somewhere in there, all of their strokes ended a perfect horizontal. Alright, very common thing about Helvetica. Another thing is that if you look at a capital R, notice how the leg doesn't start until where the bowl would have started if it were a B. So it doesn't start to way out there. It's connected more to the crossbar than it is to the stem. At the very end it just tapers just a slight bit, almost like it's a serif, but it's not. Another thing, and we usually don't look at punctuation for typefaces, for Helvetica, it can be a ringer, let you know that it is Helvetica. Notice how it's a square top with a hooked bottom for the comma. A lot of serif ones are more like teardrop-like. This one is square on top, hooked in the bottom. The A has a little foot serif. Now, not always, but generally when you see Helvetica, it has a little foot serif on the A. Which is interesting, considering, like I said, it's a sans serif typeface. Many people consider it to be the sans serif typeface. A lot of people think it's the epitome of what typefaces should be. It's clean, it's easy to read, it can be stylish. There's a number of different weights that Helvetica can be used in. Other little things, the Q, very understated. The tail or the dagger just is very, just kind of laying there at a low angle. That's like that. Again, the A, the R, and then any letter that has a stroke like that will just end in a perfect horizontal. The F is quite narrow. Notice the X height is very high. It's about 2/3 to 3/4 of the cap height, so it's a considerably high X height. The T is simple, not as simple as feature, although this one comes out and has a little bit of a finial or a tail on it, but even that's quite understated. So that's what Helvetica is. And it's designed to look like it's all one weight of stroke. Some parts like the N, the P, wherever there's like a bowl coming to a stem, it may narrow slightly, but generally it's designed to look like it's just one weight of stroke throughout. Now, let's look at something. There was a movie made about Helvetica. Some of you might have seen it. This is a funny poster about the movie. It says, "Meet the cast, A through Z," and then now see the movie Helvetica. Notice this A doesn't have a foot serif, which I think is odd, but anyway, it's a very unassuming low angle dagger in the Q. The R, again, is connected to the crossbar, not the stem, and it's a slight tail off on there. The G is a very understated foot serif there. And the K, notice how the leg connects to the arm. The leg does not connect to the stem. So this, I mean, we're talking like subtleties here to understand that this is Helvetica. Here's a Helvetica poster, and the reason why this is important is look at all these different logos, and there are many more, that use Helvetica in their logos. For example, we can see that Target uses Helvetica in their logo. That's just straight up Helvetica. The leg connects to the crossbar, slight tail off, unassuming foot serif on the G. Mattel uses it. Again, it doesn't get more straightforward than that. They use a nice little ligature with the two T's crossing, but essentially that's just however you imagine writing Mattel, that's what it looks like. Notice how theirs goes off the burst, which is nice. Here's a mug showing that Helvetica, although it can be unassuming, can actually exude quite a bit of attitude. If you light, it's kind of fancy and dainty. And the heavier you get, you know, it's more poster-like. It's heavy, it's masculine, it's compressed, things like that. And then here's a page that shows a whole bunch of different logos that use Helvetica. Even Caterpillar is a bold, a condensed version of itself. And Oral-B is an italic bold version of itself with slight ligature there and extra work done there. But these are all based on Helvetica. So that's Helvetica in a nutshell.